baby.
Larry Jones, U.S. Navy.
Eric Scott, U.S. Air Force.
And Tom Jones, United States Army.
Sir. Thank you for serving. Thank you for your service, sir.
We just got appointed to this position, and I thought it would be great to come down and feed the veterans. So we, first of all, we want to thank you guys for your service and everything y'all did for this country. And my union president is here, Rodney Lewis.
I want to thank Markael, I want to thank Rick, and thank Shanae as well. And also the Veterans Village here for allowing us to come in here and see you guys. I know you get tired of hearing this every day from everybody that walks past you, throwing up the pseudo salute. I want to tell each and every one of you, thank you for your service. And I don't think people ever truly understand the sacrifices some of you guys made physically and psychologically, mentally, everything. Those that haven't been in your position. So I want to thank you. Anything we can do for you, I will make sure these guys get cards to get back to you. Rick has always been very, very active in the veteran community. And happy to have him aboard. Markael has been doing great outreach with our locals. So. I think they're going to serve you guys well.
Senator Eddie Melton wants to thank you guys as well for your service. He'll be doing the event at the Veterans Cafe from 4 to 8, where they'll be paying for veterans to come out and eat there, too. So my wife is here from Merriam Health Center.
So we will also be in attendance at the event tonight at the Veterans Cafe, but he told me that he was coming over here to bring you guys lunch. And so at Merriam Health Center, we also brought you some goodies. Just a flyer explaining what we do. So if you guys are looking for a medical home, we do offer pediatric through adult care. We have lab, dental. It'd be great to see you. So I'll leave a bag for everybody. So thank you for having us.
So without further ado, we can kind of pass y'all food out and y'all can go ahead and eat. Y'all ain't got to get up. We'll bring it to you. We'll take this.
We are located at 501 West Ridge Road.
We're in the old priest rectory of St. Mark's Church in Gary, and we can house up to 31. Today we have about 15, 17 transitioning veterans, and as of Thursday, we have served 613 transitioning veterans. Whatever, everybody think a veteran is a drunk or a drug addict or whatever, the reason they're homeless, but that's not true at all. When they come back, one thing, I'm married to a Marine, and one thing I can tell you that is for real, that PTSD, that is for real. I tell my husband all the time, I said, I'm gonna write a book on the, you know, the war, the invisible war, because he's still fighting a war, he's a Vietnam veteran. He's still fighting a war, and so it's really true. People say, oh, they're crazy. No, they're not crazy. They saw so much when they were over there. You know, at night, he can't sleep with the lights off, you know. And when he's sleeping, he's running, you know, running from the enemy. At first, I was saying, that's crazy. I didn't know what was going on. I didn't understand that. But I talk with a lot of wives now that deal with that same thing. So, again, we thank you. This is for real. We thank you. We thank you.
First of all, thank you all for coming out tonight. Before I was a senator, before I was a husband, I was a son of a veteran. And my father served. He's still alive, thank God. I still have him in my life. He's a disabled veteran. I was just messing with friends of his, I've known him years ago. He should be coming later on tonight. But when you find good people that's doing good things, we should support them. It takes a lot to put your whole life and invest it into something for the sake of others. And to me, that's serving leadership. We talk about leadership a lot in the community. To me, that's serving leadership, being selfless, not being selfish. And this is a living example of that. One of the things I just hope that tonight was going to do is just shed more light on the restaurant, the benefit and the hard work and the sweat equity that goes into this restaurant goes to support your good work. And I want to thank those that's in the background, y'all. Yeah. Don't be quiet. Yeah. 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 Right. But you know, I don't want to be long. But I was just say this: God has blessed me with the opportunity to serve with the state senate. This is my first year, and I serve on the Veterans Committee for the state. And I consider that as an honor to be able to articulate the concerns and the issues that I hear from veterans one-on-one. You know, why did I go all the way to Jesse Brown in Chicago? Why can't I go here? And the quality, service, attention, and in terms of respect of putting your life on the line. You know, far too often we just gloss over it. There's a day, a Veterans Day, but every day should be
Veterans
Day.
Every day.
You know, because our freedom,
being
here, breaking bread, people right now are putting their life on the line so that we remain free. And we cannot take that for granted. So I just want to say that. And I want to just thank Master Sergeant Allen. He is recognized by the governor as the top, help me out here.
I've known Eddie for a decade now, it's been many years, and you know, as a veteran, as a member of American Legion, Post 270, and it just warms my heart to hear your words. And you know, I know the background is deeper, and I know that you know, your words are 100% true and honest, and I really appreciate you coming out to the community and really recognizing the veterans here, and really just being a resource for us and the strategic support. So. With the title, American Military Person of the Year.
All right.
We had a wonderful day. Earlier today, we was at the Northwest Indiana Veterans Village. We fed 40 veterans, United Steelworkers, Local 1014. We raised the money to feed the veterans today, and it was a great event. And we had food was cooked here at the Veterans Cafe. So it was a good day. We enjoyed great company with the veterans. You know, it's just something that we all should do and take a conscious effort to support our veterans and thank them for their service to this country. Because a lot of the things that we take for granted, we wouldn't have it if it wasn't for the veterans. So this is always something special to me. My dad was a veteran, my brother was a veteran. I'm sure everybody knows somebody who's a veteran. So don't make it just one day. Every day, go out and try to do something to support a veteran.
What's up, everyone? This is Senator Eddie Melton. I'm just excited. We're here at the Veterans Cafe and Grill. We had a fantastic day. We had many people to come out and support this organization, dine and purchase food for veterans that live in veteran shelters throughout Northwest Indiana. But today we had an opportunity to really give back and serve, and also just meet and talk to people throughout the community and listen to some of the veterans and their concerns and issues. But I just want to encourage everyone to support the Veterans Cafe and Grill here in Maryville, Indiana. And just come on out, bring them here, bring your family here, bring a veteran here, or come in and purchase them a meal and take it to them. I think they'll definitely benefit from it. But I want to thank everyone that helped make today a success. United Steelworkers Local 1014, Markael Watkins, and President Rodney Lewis for delivering meals to veterans in Northwest Indiana, Veterans Village in Gary, Indiana. I want to thank Shanae Watkins and Maryland Health for coming here to just talk about health care and health needs of the veterans throughout our community and just encouraging folks to be better stewards of our bodies and minds. So, again, I want to thank you all for supporting us and continue to support this organization and continue to support our veterans as they protect us. When they come back home, we want to make sure that they have every service and need that they deserve and that they fought for in this country. So thank you, God bless you, and come to Veterans Cafe and Grill in the future.